Hey, what's up, YouTube?
Hello.
It is Andrew and Brittany coming at you here right now with our first official, I just realized this is technically our first official adventure video.
It's official.
And fate should have it that we have a couple of really awesome friends. So giving those guys a shout out right now.
Yay, friends.
Who are watching. Thank you, friends. You know who you are. But they have actually given us a free night at the Coeur d'Alene Resort to go and check it out, see the shops, all the cool things that they have there.
Yeah.
So we're really excited for this to be our first official adventure. This is going to be awesome. So thank you to those people. But before we even do that, Brittany, what do we got to do?
Coffee. Got to go get coffee, right?
Yes.
Right?
Yep.
I'm more excited.
She's practically falling asleep right now.
I'm more excited. So we're going to go to one of my favorite local coffee shops right now and get some Java, get some caffeine in my bloodstream and some in his too.
Yes, yes.
He secretly likes coffee just as much as I do.
Just a little bit.
So let's go.
Yeah, let's do it.
Please.
Got our coffee, got back into the car with only minor spillage.
I did just spill half of this on my pants.
Yep,
so,
only a little bit.
But I salvaged some, so we're good.
Yep, the most important part, there's still coffee to drink, and that is what
counts.
Otherwise,
I'd be in tears.
Yes.
Or back inside ordering.
And I would probably be laughing. Anyway, so Thomas Hammer is probably one of our favorite places to get coffee in Coeur d'Alene and Hayden. This shop that we went to today is actually in Hayden. This one holds a lot of sentimental value for both Brittany and I. Several years ago, before we were even married, we were in an internship together. And just to get through the long internship hours, it sometimes required a good caffeine fix
that
or a sweet pick-me-up.
That is where my addiction to caffeine started. Yeah, as Drew said, we're in Hayden right now. And we have another location that we'll have to take you guys to soon.
Yes, another video.
It's over in Coeur d'Alene, very far away. If you live here, you know that's very close. Mm-hmm. But there's another locations got a very different feel to it.
Very different. And it's surprising too.
It is, yeah. It's got a more this one's pretty modern too, but it's got a more modern feel to it, even more than this one. And it's in a different part of town. So right here the Hayden location's more in a residential area and the other location's more by the freeway. So we'll have to take you there sometime. So, Drew, tell them what you're drinking.
Yeah, so today I actually got one of my newest favorites. Brittany knows this. I've kind of bounced between different drinks as my favorite. At first it was the Jackhammer, then it went to Carmanilla. But right now, mine is a Frizz coffee. Now, Brittany knows more about this drink than I do. All I know is that it's good,
tastes good
and it's frizzy. So, Brittany, what is this?
Frizz coffee, it's an Italian drink, Italian bottled drink beverage, and it's basically carbonated coffee, a little caramel flavor, and Drew orders it with a little vanilla and cream, and it's basically like a root beer float with coffee. And it's ridiculously good.
Now, I will say about the Frizz coffees, I was not sold at first, and I remember when Brittany brought it home to me one day, she's like, here, try this, and I took the first step, and I was not expecting the carbonation. Yeah. Like, it actually kind of made me jump a little bit because I'm like, what the heck is this?
You got to know it's carbonated first.
Yes. And so it threw me off. I finished the first drink and Brittany called me coming home from work one day and she's like, hey, do you want me to swing by and get a coffee for you? And she asked me what kind. I said, hey, you know what? Give me another one of those Frizz coffees. I'll give it a second shot. And sure enough, I finished the second cup and I think it's the coolest thing in the world. And I'm super excited for summer because I could totally see this being a huge summertime refreshing drink, walking downtown Coeur d'Alene on the beach with this in your hand. Couldn't be any better.
So if you like root beer floats and coffee, you gotta try a Frizz coffee with vanilla and cream.
Yeah.
And then I got one of my favorite treat drinks. Now, I don't normally drink this, I normally, I'll show you what I drink normally a different day, but this is very similar. Just got a little treat in it. So I got a Jackhammer, which is, it's got dark chocolate. It's a latte, so it's got some espresso, some dark chocolate, honey, and cinnamon. And you think a lot of people are like honey and coffee, but yeah. That's my favorite thing. And it's got just a comfort taste to it. Got a little allergies going on. So I got a little sore throat. So I wanted a comfort drink. But it's spring here. So
yeah.
Well, that means summer's coming. So allergies are good.
All right. So that has been our coffee run.
Coffee run.
We have
done.
Our coffee, and now I think it's time to
now
head down
set.
To the resort. Into the resort.
We made it.
We got parked.
No accidents.
No accidents. That's the important part. Now we're just trying to get to the elevators. There's only one elevator tower for the parking garage. So we're just about there now, and we'll get down to the main lobby. Quick game, which elevator is going to open first? Brittany thinks it's a left. What do you think it's going to be? Left or right? Guess now. Okay, so Brittany's going to explain which elevator won because I'm confused.
I technically won because the right one did open, but there was a group full of prom people in there, so we didn't go in there. But then the left elevator opened, and that's the one we went in. So based on elevators that we rode, my elevator wins. But based on elevators that opened first, I lose. So
if you were guessing,
very
then...
Very confusing.
Yeah, very confusing, but
we
made it.
I like the one that I win, so...
Yeah, so we'll let Brittany win on this one. So right now, once you get in the parking garage and you get down to the bottom, it spits you out right where their convention wings are. And the doors are closed, so I don't think we're going to be able to get in there. But we're going to walk through the main lobby, and we'll kind of show you guys what's along the way. And we'll get to the other tower of elevators, which were the south elevator tower. And then that's how you get to all of the rooms. So we'll head that way. Okay, so I promise... We were so gonna show you guys more of the lobby.
I got embarrassed.
But it is crazy busy here right now. We totally spaced that it's prom for like several high schools, and we felt really bad walking around with the camera and maybe making some people feel kind of creepy that way. Yeah. So what we're gonna do is we promise we'll make another video where we come back. There's a whole bunch of stuff in the lobby, including the little
tank.
Yeah, giant fish tanks, several stores, and a whole bunch of really cool things. So including a restaurant called Gooey's.
Yeah.
So again, we definitely wanna show you guys those things, but we didn't wanna creep people out this time. But we figured, at least for now, we can actually show you guys a penthouse. So that's one thing I didn't even realize until we got the room keys, was that it's not just a regular hotel room. This is one of the penthouses in the Coeur d'Alene stinking resort. So this is gonna be pretty stinking cool. Let's go check it out. We're looking for 1802, penthouse 1802. So if you're gonna ever stay in a penthouse, pay attention to walls because they're not, oh, was this it? Oh, sweet, look at that. Brittany, go ahead, would you take that? You just ring the doorbell. Fortunately.
Making sure no one's in there.
Yeah, there we go, making sure that it's ours. Oh my gosh, this is gonna be awesome. This is gonna be the big reveal.
Welcome to my crib.
This is Brittany's crib.
Wow.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, check this out. Oh my gosh, and there's a cruise boat going by right now. Can you guys see this? Oh my gosh. So gonna give you guys a quick tour of the penthouse of the Coeur d'Alene Resort right here. So this is actually the entryway. So when you walk in, you can actually go to the right. And this is where you got the little kind of goodie bar with a good old fashioned. Yeah, I got the caffeine station, got the mini fridge. Brittany, what's in there?
Got to see what's in the mini fridge.
Wow.
All the alcoholic necessities.
Wait.
But
Capri Sun.
The most important thing, the Capri Sun.
I've never seen this kind. Looks good.
That's pretty cool.
Red Bull VA. Wait.
Look at that.
Should have had a V8.
Should have had a
V8. This is not sponsored by them.
No, not at all.
But if you'd want to sponsor, you work for me.
All right, so going to give you guys a quick tour of the penthouse of the Coeur d'Alene Resort right here. So this is actually the entryway. So when you walk in, you can actually go to the right. And this is where you got the little kind of goodie bar with a good old fashioned. Yeah, I got the caffeine station. Got the mini fridge. Brittany, what's in there? Got to see what's in the mini fridge.
Wow.
All the alcoholic necessities.
Wait.
But
Capri Sun.
The most important thing, the Capri Sun.
I've never seen this kind. Looks good.
That's pretty cool.
Red Bull VA. Wait.
Look at that.
Should have had a V8.
Should have had a
V8. This is not sponsored by them.
No, not at all.
But if you'd want to sponsor, you work for me.
Okay, so in the last portion of the video, you heard our room's doorbell go off, so we had to abruptly stop and cut the video. But when I answered, there was a lady at the door, and she gave us a couple of really cool things. Check this out.
Chocolate.
Got some chocolate.
My favorite.
Yep.
And a little card.
Little card.
And it says, I'm gonna read it to you. It says, when you awaken tomorrow, you can expect the following weather. A high of 52 degrees Fahrenheit and a low of 29 degrees Fahrenheit. Should you require anything to make your evening more comfortable, please call guest services.
How thoughtful of them.
We have chocolate now.
And chocolate. Pretty stinking cool. So resuming the tour that we were just on before we got our chocolate and weather card. So you walked into the right and you had this amazing bar full of goodies and V8 juice. But then right over here, you got the dual sink action going on, got some complimentary soaps and body wash and water glasses. So then coming over from the sinks, you got this room right in here, which has a toilet and for when you find yourself doing a long sitting and you have a business call, you got a phone right there. Or if you've fallen and you can't get up, I'm assuming that's what that's for. But check out this shower. This thing kind of freaked me out at first. So you got the water control on this side, but the water doesn't come out all the way over there. Check that out. This shower is legitimately, it is so huge. It's crazy. So for reference, I'm back at the front door where we just checked out all of this awesome stuff right in there. But if you were to continue to go straight into the room, you have this amazing huge bed. I think it's a king size bed. I'm not 100% sure. Got a couple of lights on either side, some reading lights. Got this awesome drawer so you can kind of keep some of your stuff in there, and it looks like a phone book as well. Got another phone down there in case you have any phone calls you need to make. Step right down in here into the living room. Got a couple of really nice plush soft blue chairs, a table in case you have stuff that you want to set out. Got a little gift bag there. Check out some Fiji water. That's pretty stinking awesome. But I mean, the main thing about this room, guys, it is legitimately this view. This is Coeur d'Alene, stinking lake right here. I'm telling you, this is probably one of the most beautiful places on the planet. Man, this is just so crazy. You can kind of see Tubbs. This is Tubbs Hill right here. A lot of locals, we like to hike there in the summer. And this is actually the beginning of the hiking trail, and you can hike all the way around Tubbs. Takes a little bit, but that's pretty awesome. This is the public boat launch. So this place right here, it's all pretty crazy in the summer. It gets really busy, a lot of boats launching. This is the boardwalk, the resort's boardwalk. And I believe, if I'm remembering correctly, it is the longest floating boardwalk in the world.
That's true, we Googled it yesterday.
Yeah, that's, Brittany's confirming that. It's true, we Googled it yesterday. So it is the longest floating boardwalk in the world. Looking towards the back of the room, there I am, what's up? But you got the front door that's just right over there, so that's where we walked in. But here, if you see on this side of the bed, there's a little doorway here. So we're gonna walk in here, just so you guys can kind of see. So you walk through here, and if you look to your right, there's the front entrance. There's Brittany. Hi, Brittany. There's the front entrance for reference. So that's where we turned in right. And then you got the shower and everything right in there. But if you were to take a left and you were to go into this side room, just when you thought a shower, one shower wasn't good enough, here is a huge, ginormous jacuzzi. It's pretty stinking big. But now we're gonna check out the balcony right out here. So you step out into the balcony, you got a really cool little seating area with a couple of chairs. Pretty sweet laying down pad right there. Man, I can only imagine this right here in the summer, but man, again, just look at this. This is incredible. So again, like I showed you before, you got Tubbs Hill, you got the public boat launch, and then this right here, you kind of saw it before, but this is actually McEwen Park. And this is a newer park that's in Coeur d'Alene. It's only a couple of years old, but it's actually really cool. So expect a video of Brittany and I showing you around some of the cool artwork and stuff that the city did there. But just check this out. There's this really strange little hallway here. And that is actually a door that connects to the other room right back there. But there's really nothing else to this hall other than, I guess, this really cool artwork. So I guess I'll give these a shout out. The artwork in a hallway that people never see. It's pretty cool. Okay, so one thing that Brittany and I noticed when we got here was there's no TV. And that's typically a standard thing when you're in a hotel room, I think. Right, Britt?
Normally, I feel
yeah,
like there's TV.
Normally. And so Brittany noticed that there were actually these remotes that were sitting on the bed.
You just wait.
Yeah, just watch this. Brittany, would you just, what's going on with these remotes here?
So we got a couple of remotes here. We got a TV remote. And where's the TV? Well, I figured that out. There's a remote here. And it's got up and down buttons. Like, what goes up and down? The TV? I don't know about you, but I think that's awesome. And you don't even have to hold it down. You just press up and it goes up. There. Mind-blowing.
This place.
Awesome.
Amazing.
Jinx.
Yeah, Jinx, you owe me a soda, right? No, this place is absolutely incredible. Penthouse suite, vibes, views. All of it. It's all here. It's pretty stinking cool.
Chilly. Literally cool.
Yeah, it's a little windy up here, so hopefully the audio on this is turning out decent. But man, we're really excited to show you guys the lobby, and Gooey's. We're going to pay a visit to Gooey's in our next video.
If you
video.
Don't know what that is, you will in
yeah.
a different video.
Yes, and you will want to come and visit Gooey's
yes.
with us next time.
It
it's going to be awesome.
It has ice cream, so...
Well, more than that.
That's
ice cream,
word.
Cobbler.
Oh.
Cobbler is my jam, and they have the best huckleberry cobbler around, which is pretty stinking awesome. But for this video, that is going to do it for now, and so we'll see you in the next one.